enthusiasts, welcome to a special series of celebrating World MSME Day. This is Neha Vasudkargate from Machine Maker, and I'll be your host for this special series where I'll be taking you through a very special journey or an amazing journey where I'll be discussing few initiatives of governments and how they support MSMEs to grow and thrive in the industry. So for the same, we have a very special guest with us, Ms. Nazia, and she'll be actually guiding us through the initiative and supports that government gives to MSMEs. So please, Nazia.
Hi everyone, I'm Nazia Syed, your friendly chartered accountant, and I'm your guide on this journey. I can't wait to take a dive into this topic, Neha. Thanks for having me here.
Amazing, so glad to have you, Nazia. So before we start, Nazia, can we just play a quick game?
Sure, why not?
Okay. So this game, or you know, this quick rapid fire round is all about that I'll be asking you one word.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you'll be answering to that, or you'll be replying to that one word in the way or in the format wherein an MSME would hear that word, what would an MSME say?
Ah, got it.
Yeah? Ready, Nazia?
Absolutely.
Okay. Finance?
Unavailable.
Okay. Cash flow?
Nightmares.
Government subsidy?
Only for large players. Are they for real?
Okay. Maybe technology?
Very expensive.
That's really bad. Tapping overseas market?
Unreachable.
And expansion?
A dream.
So that's what we are actually going to talk about in today's episode, Nazia. That, you know, how MSMEs could actually get out of these financial difficulties or get rid of these financial nightmares and turn it into a sweet dream.
Sure, Neha.
Yeah. So let's deep dive into the government initiatives, the
let's
incentives,
in.
The subsidies that would actually help MSMEs to get rid of all of these problems.
Absolutely.
And strengthen the MSME in all. So let's get this thing started. You know, access to finance is a very big topic over here. So why is it tricky for small entrepreneurs to get funding to get their things or operations started?
So Neha, see, generally banks would like to secure their lendings. So they need collaterals.
Yeah.
And this is the main roadblocks for small businesses, because they get stuck when providing adequate collaterals or guarantees. And that's where they actually struggle in taking the traditional loans.
All right. And when you say that they struggle in getting the traditional loans,
mm-hmm.
so what is the, you know, how do they navigate, or what is the road out there?
By increasing their awareness of the government support available. So
yeah.
Are you aware that the government is running a scheme to ensure collateral-free loans to small businesses?
Oh, collateral-free loans to
yep.
small enterprises. Now that sounds music to my ears. So Nazia, moving on to the dreaded cash flow problems. So can you explain what is the flow there, or what is the deal there?
Yeah. So lack of proper management. Actually, cash flow issues crops up largely from delayed payment from clients and high operating cost, etc. And if not attended to at the right time properly, this can really strain business operations.
Okay. So I would like to just say this is a very good weather, and we are actually sitting in a very nice atmosphere. So why don't we take a coffee break?
Sure. Why not?
Let's move on. So basically, you mean to say that there are delayed payments and they are chasing clients for recovery.
Yeah.
So how can our MSME friends actually deal with these kind of problems
yeah.
or situations?
Yeah. By negotiating better credit terms with their clients. So are you aware that the MSME Act has legal provisions to ensure that payments to small enterprises are made maximum within 15 to 45 days?
Oh,
that's it. Yeah.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
That's,
and not just that, Neha, in fact, to ensure strict compliance with this provision, there are severe monetary implications for the buyer
okay.
if they don't follow this. Government has also implemented factoring mechanism where basically you can sell your receivables for a discount and have a quick cash in your hands.
That's really nice. That's a really great government initiative, Nazia. So what you're trying to tell over here is, or say over here is, so there are speedy recovery for small businesses by which they can ensure that these processes are implemented properly, right?
Yeah.
So if these issues are implemented properly or resolved properly, they can actually have their resolvements in the cash flow, right? Apart from that, can you also talk about high interest rates? Mm-hmm. Because that is such a burden for an MSME. Mm-hmm. So how they can deal with them?
Yeah. By availing government support and grants, etc., which has been made available to tackle these problems particularly.
So, speaking of government help, so what are some subsidies or, you know, support that government is helping for the MSMEs? You can actually dive deep into it, because MSME friends really need to know about these kind of, you know, subsidies or help that the government is actually.
Yeah, sure, Neha. So there are quite a few. In fact, we just spoke of a credit guarantee scheme for micro small enterprises, which is focusing on fund availability issue. Then there is a marketing and procurement scheme, procurement support scheme, which is aiming at improving the marketing capabilities of our small players. There is MSME champion scheme working on innovation, sustainability. There are quite a few schemes at the central government level under the Make in India initiatives of our government. In addition to that, every state, Neha, has their own state level policy, which is working to resolve industry issues and support entrepreneurs. And these schemes are very well catering to the MSME players as well. In fact, Neha, to add, our very own state Maharashtra government has a package scheme of incentive which is operative right from 1964.
Okay.
And it has been amended from time to time to meet the current needs of the players.
All right.
So there are quite a few available around.
And are these schemes really known to the MSMEs, or are they really unaware about? Because what happens is when an MSME actually gets into the business, they're really trying their, you know, level hard to get their business onto a big level.
Yeah.
But, you know, when these schemes get ticking off, so how do they get to know about these schemes? How is there any, you know, platform, or how, what is the help that they would get?
Yeah. So lack of awareness is the main problem, actually. So because schemes are there in place, government is offering the required support. The lack of awareness is a main problem. And in this regard, see, this is the platform, right? You, people like you, I, and then many more who are informed about the scheme, they are doing their best to ensure that this information is made aware of to the MSMEs.
Yeah, right. This is actually a very great, fantastic lifelines that you have actually told us. So any quick tips to ace these application processes?
Yeah. So Neha, it's very important to remember here that pre-planning is a key. You should not be looking at these once you have incurred your investment. So it's important for our friends to understand that they should understand the eligibility criteria of these schemes, plan their investments wisely so to ensure that they fit into the eligibility criteria, and definitely not hesitate taking professional help to navigate the whole process smoothly.
Okay, that's actually very much enlightening. And before we wrap up, any quick tips that you would like to give to our MSME friends? Any kind of from your side that you would like
to give? Sure, Neha, why not? So I would like to say that finances appear challenging only until we actually plan to tackle them wisely. So I would like to just say that stay informed, be proactive, and avail of the support that is available around.
That's a wonderful advice, Nazia. Thank you for being with us today. And I am sure our viewers and the MSME friends would have find this episode quite valuable.
Thank you, Neha, for having me here. It was my pleasure to share all of these insights.
Great. Thank you, Nazia. This was a really great episode. And thank you, our viewers. Stay tuned for more such insightful episodes, where we'll be taking you a deeper dive into all these government initiatives and supports.
Sure, Neha, your viewers won't want to miss it, because we'll be sharing some game-changing insights here.
So I'm sure you must have found this episode interesting. So don't forget to like the hit button.
Yeah, and don't forget to comment below with your financial challenges. We'll try to address them in our coming episode.
See you the next time. And until then, keep thriving and keep innovating. See you.
Yeah, wish you all a happy MSME day.